Elam, my guy, what are you doing to us? And by us, I mean the crypto community. With the tweets that Elon has been pumping out the past week, there's been some drama on Twitter, as well as just the crypto space in general, because crypto prices are coming down. So I want to talk about the drama because it's juicy and I wanted to make a video about it. And then also, towards the end of the video, I want to talk about Bitcoin and kind of where I think it is in this bull cycle. Now, I don't do a ton of short-term predictions when it comes to pricing, but I do want to talk about the stock-to-flow model, which has tracked the price pretty decently in the past. On May 12th, Elon sends out a tweet about Tesla and Bitcoin. He attaches a picture showing that they'll be suspending the vehicle purchases with Bitcoin going forward. The main concern is environmental issues when it comes to Bitcoin and Bitcoin mining. Now, it's important to remember that Tesla bought $1.5 billion worth of Bitcoin back in February. During their Q1 earnings, they also announced that they had sold $272 million worth of Bitcoin, making a profit on their earlier purchase. Knowingly sending out that tweet, Elon must have known it was going to take down the Bitcoin price. So the question is, are they going to sell the rest of their Bitcoin or hold it? Or what are they doing with their Bitcoin on the balance sheet? Well, according to the last part of the tweet, they're not planning on selling any Bitcoin and waiting for the energy to be more sustainable in order to accept it for transactions in the future. Then only days later, someone tweets about Tesla maybe getting rid of their holdings or dumping it, and Elon responds to that tweet with, "Indeed," but then later tweets to clarify speculation Tesla has not sold any Bitcoin. So I don't know, this guy's a complete wild card, so who knows what they actually did. Now there's two points that are interesting about this. One, they bought $1.5 billion worth of an asset that they did not realize could be bad for energy consumption when it comes to proof of work or how Bitcoin actually works. Secondly, you have Dogecoin, right? Elon loves memes, he loves Dogecoin. And the guy's been pumping it via tweets, via SNL. He constantly mentions his Dogecoin. So it's kind of a joke to him that he can take a cryptocurrency like Dogecoin, promote it, and definitely moves markets and can manipulate people into thinking, oh, Dogecoin can actually transition to not only become more than a meme coin, but beat out something like Bitcoin. And this obsession with Dogecoin is obvious when he tweets out May 13th, the day after, that he's been working with devs to potentially improve Dogecoin. So all of a sudden, Elon is against Bitcoin, but he loves Dogecoin. Then he goes on to talk about how Dogecoin can be improved to increase the throughput and lower transaction fees with a pretty easy upgrade. Now there's a couple funny things about that, because what he's suggesting of increasing the block size to increase throughput and lower transaction fees is kind of like what happened with Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash. The whole thought of Bitcoin Cash was we're going to increase the block size and make things faster in terms of transactions and lower the transaction fees. But what happens on scalability over the long term is that block size, just increasing it, can cause issues. And then two, why is he doing it with Dogecoin? Why not create a new cryptocurrency that, you know, maybe has the throughput or the transaction fees that you're looking for? That's what's a little confusing. Why Dogecoin? Other than the fact that it's a complete meme and people are kind of rallied around Dogecoin because it's this thing that made a bunch of people rich, and not necessarily for anything other than, hey, it's a meme coin, this is kind of funny. Oh, look at it, the price is going up, everyone piles in. So we'll see if Dogecoin kind of can sustain these price levels and market cap. And by kind of forcing this narrative of Dogecoin is going to improve, Dogecoin is the next Bitcoin, it seems like Elon is like propping up Dogecoin so it doesn't collapse.
So that's pretty much all the drama going on. But regardless, he is only one guy and it shouldn't matter what's going on with Elon. In the long term, these pullbacks, you can see the crypto market in general is falling down a pretty decent amount over the past 7 days. But Elon has no control over the long term of the entire crypto market. Just remember that.
So I don't love to do short-term predictions because cryptocurrency is pretty random, and cryptocurrency for me is a long-term play still in terms of 5-10 years, because at that point, once it becomes used as a currency, it's no longer a way to make money for me. So for me, 5-10 years, I think there's still growth potential, so I want to own a percentage in my portfolio.
How I do that, I own a certain percentage of my net worth in cryptocurrency. If it gets above that level, I trim. If it gets way below it, you know, I start to add more to my cryptocurrency position. It's worked out pretty well because I tend to trim during huge bull runs and then I'm adding during bear runs. That's how it's worked out for me.
One interesting graph to look at while we have this pullback is the stock to flow model, which is a way to kind of compare Bitcoin's price with commodities and the fact that there's only a limited supply with Bitcoin. Looking back in the past, this model has predicted Bitcoin's price pretty well. Not saying that the past results definitely means that the future results are going to be the same, but this model has done a pretty good job, so I like to look at it. We're around above 1,000 days to the next halving. You can see based on this model that the end of the bull run, according to this, is kind of coming up, but it's not completely over. So these pullbacks, 30-40%, are normal, and there can be a blow-off top when it comes to price action towards the end of the bull market, kind of like in 2018 or the beginning of 2018 or end of 2017, 2014, going into 2015. All these blow off the top bull runs kind of shoot up, realize, okay, this is way too euphoric, and then kind of come down over the next couple of years.
But back to the price prediction, I think Bitcoin can get to $100,000 or over $100,000 still in 2021. And I think the bear market starts at some point in 2022 where we trend down a couple of years after kind of all this euphoric stuff has gone on. As I've talked about in previous TikToks or Instagram posts, the shit coins or the meme coins, when those are popping off, that's kind of when I get worried. Now that's has been going on and it does worry me. But looking at that stock to flow model, I think we still have a little bit more to go. For me, I've trimmed a little bit of my position. So it's kind of if we keep on going up, I still have a stake in the bull run. If we come down a decent amount, well then now I can start loading up for 2024, 2025, kind of that time period. So now you kind of have a summarized version of what's going on with Elon Musk in the crypto space and all the crazy drama that's going on. It's kind of fun, you know, to laugh about it while we're all losing money on our crypto positions. Anyway, I appreciate you guys watching. If you did enjoy the video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to Main Street Wolf, where we talk about crypto, investing, options, anything to do with money. Thanks guys for watching and have a great day.